Hi, hello, hola, yo, this is Jay, and today we will see how to import points or coordinates of complex curves such as airfoil from Excel to CATIA. So without wasting our time, let's get started. So first we'll open Sketcher, we'll go to Mechanical Design and Sketcher. We'll rename it as Airfoil, and here we are. So now you need the coordinate files of the curve. Well, here I have got mine, and these are the X and Y coordinates of the airfoil. So you need to copy them into another file. So this is a special file we will be needing. So you can download this file from my website for free. You just have to visit the link I have given in the description. So we'll open this file, and this is the file. So now we just have to copy the coordinates of the airfoil into that file. So we'll just copy these, and before copying, well, let me tell you one thing. So we are going to plot the airfoil on YZ plane here, and we have the coordinates as X and Y. So we'll just transform them. So we'll just treat the X and Y coordinates as Y and Z coordinates. So in this file, the special file, it is named as Generative Shape Design Spline from Excel. So in this file, the first column denotes X coordinate, the second column denotes Y coordinate, and the third column denotes Z coordinate. So as we are going to treat the X and Y coordinates as Y and Z, we are going to copy and paste them here. That's it. So we'll just push it down below. Okay. So now that we have Y and Z, we need to enter the X coordinates as 0. And every X coordinate will be 0. So that's it, we have all the three coordinates for the airfoil. So now if the Excel is warning you that the macros have been disabled, go to options and click on enable this content and click OK. After that, go to view, and in the right side you'll see macros. Go to macros, click on view macros, and then select FEUIL 1.main, fuel main. In macros, in select the generative shape design file and click on run. So now it is asking you to enter 1 or 2 or 3. So type in the kind of entities you want to create. So if you enter 1 and click on OK, you'll just get all the points on the sketcher, and if you enter 2, then you'll get the points as well as the curve. So we'll see both of them. We'll go for point 1 first, click on OK, and then we'll go to CATIA. So as you can see, all the points are being imported and generated over here, and here they are. Here is our airfoil, see, right? So now we'll check out option number 2. We'll delete this. And we'll go again to the generative shape design file. We'll again go in view macros, fuel.1, generative shape design, run, enter 2, and OK. So we'll visit the CATIA again and see. Here you have got all the points along with the curve. That's it. Easy, right? So now if you want to transform this 2D airfoil into a 3D wing, well, I have got another tutorial for you. You can check it out. I have mentioned different types of methods of doing it. So if you like the video, then please leave us a like below. If you thought that the video was helpful, then please subscribe my channel so that I could even help you in the future. And don't forget that link for downloading the file is given in the description. So that's all for today, guys. Adios, sayonara, goodbye, bye bye.